the difference between a remix and an original track, I think sometimes it's very, you know, quite close, because if you're doing a remix, it depends. I've done mixes before where I've just stripped it completely and basically just like writing a new track in the past. Now I tend to sort of really keep the original in there, but just give it a little bit of me, you know. I've just done a Gus Gus mix and that should be coming out soon. So I'd like to keep great vocals. You want to keep, you know, the reason why you do it because you love the track, right? So you don't want to sort of completely twist it like it's yours. When you're doing your own one, of course, you've got a blank canvas. So it's like, you know, it's you go from wherever you want to start off. Most memorable things that have happened to me in the past, there's going to be loads of those, aren't there? There's too many, of course. Meeting my beautiful love of my life, Gemma, over there. having babies, you know, that's one of the most memorable things you'll never forget, right, your kids. And then on the music side of it, you know, there's been so many great moments. Being in Underworld was one of the best things, like doing some special events, like doing Glastonbury main stage on the Pyramid stage, like on the penultimate, just after Texas and before the Manic Street Preachers. So we was on the Saturday night and it was just dusk, and then as the lights were going, you know, as it was getting darker, our light show came on. Then, you know, you just don't forget that image of looking out at Glastonbury, beautiful weather as well, and just all the little bonfires, just a crowd of people. You know, and I've done a few like that with Underworld, you know. We had some great ones in Japan at the base of Mount Fuji. There's a big list with that. Playing, and also Japan for me is great memories there. You know, that's one of my sort of home from home. I go there a lot every January or around that time. I tend to go out there these days. But I've been going over for 25 years. I was one of the first one electronic DJs to go out there and sort of take techno over there from the early 90s. And it was very weird when I went there then, but it's changed so much. It's got more westernised now. So Japan, South America's always been fantastic. Buenos Aires, got great moments. Doing the Global Underground show, CDs, the compilations, down in Uruguay, Punta del Este, that was pretty special. We had Sasha down there when I was doing my set, and Lee Burridge and a few people like that. So we had a good party, I always remember that one. So, you know, great parties and you know, hopefully many more. We'll be right back. club music scene, you know, the music sort of tends to sort of come, the production's definitely got a lot smoother with, you know, fantastic digital plugins that are sort of like copying the old school analog ones. But, you know, analog's coming back as well, is what I'm saying. Everything's going round again. So I like the fact that you're getting some really cool analog sort of pieces of hardware again, and people cloning old things and that. So it's great to have the analog stuff. I like digital as well, but I still like a bit of the old school vibe, you know. I think it sort of goes around with the club thing, exactly the same thing with the music as well. It starts, the old stuff comes back again. It sort of goes round and round. I can't seem to sort of hear anything brand new that's sounding, you know. There's always going to be some sort of thing that, oh, it sounds a bit like that, really, you know. And I think Acid Ass was the last sort of thing that really was a new sound, that movement, you know, and especially the acid sound, the 303. I just got lost in it, I loved it, you know. So that's just like, and it, you know, just so there's not much difference, you know, the clubs. The one thing I don't like about these days of the digital age is the phones and the way people go to clubs now, where in the old days, it weren't about looking at the DJ, it was about just getting down into your little groove on the dance floor. But now it's a big performance and the DJ is the superstar, which is great, you know, and it's cool, I don't really want, I don't thrive off that. I'd rather see people take their phones down and getting down, not even staring at me, and getting lost in what I'm doing. That would be, you know, amazing. But, you know, there's a few clubs that tend to sort of like say, you know, more phones. And I quite like that angle, and I think that should carry on, you know, ban phones. But that's the only thing that's sort of bad, you know, but the music goes around. It's still some great music coming out. Sometimes there's, but then, and again, there's a lot of shit coming out every day, weekly. It's more disposable. Using the Denon media players and the mixer, they're cool, you know, they're really good. They feel good, they're sounding good, the mix is cool. There's a lot of stuff you can do. I think on this mix, you know, you can get under the bonnet a little bit and tweak it and personalise the way you're doing it. I think you can do that with most of them, but it felt good. It felt like, I do like the hotkey thing at the bottom of the media players. I think that's really cool with the loops, and you can do your own loops on that as well. So yeah, I think in general, I think they're great. You know, they're sort of up there with the big boys, and I think they're, you know, I think you'll be seeing a lot of them. I think they're good. I like my tech. If I've been asked to try something new, you know, I'll give it a go. And I think they were good. I enjoyed working on them today. To be a part of this lovely project, the reason why I'm here is because one thing, you know, I was told it was going to be in Venice. I've never been to Venice, and I just got saw where we was going to do it. We're in this beautiful place here, you know, and it's a special thing, you know. And I know the producer and then the guy that's doing this film is fantastic at his job, and he's going to do a very, very good job of this. So it was lovely to come here. You know, I've met some lovely people. The guys that run it are fantastic. You know, we've met some nice people. Met some other DJs that were doing it yesterday and the day before. And you know, we've had a really nice time. The weather's been good to us yesterday. It weren't so good today, so we've done the filming today. So it's worked out really well. So now I've had a fantastic time, and I'll do it again definitely.
Yeah.